trying to learn how to do that. These are called pinch harmonics, and I'm gonna prepare you with a few tips that's gonna make this a whole lot easier as you practice on this. Nothing to do with your fretting hand at all, nothing to do with your guitar tone, nothing to do with your gear. It all has to do with your picking hand. Let's get started. If you have them available, fresh strings. Next, get you a 1mm pick or larger. Also, make sure you have your bridge pickup selected, as this will make it a little easier. Turn up your distortion, but don't overdo it. I find pinch harmonics a lot easier to get out when you are on the third string from the bottom. However, don't limit yourself to the third string. Try others too. You'll want to choke up on the pick a little bit to where you've got not much of the pick sticking out between your fingers. If this helps, just put your pick down, pick it back up. How did you hold your pick? Don't change it, just lessen up the amount of pick that's sticking out between your fingers. The string is coming up over the pick, and I like to say it's launching off of it and it's slapping your thumb right afterwards. I'm angling the pick just down a little bit like this instead of picking, you know, straight on like this. You dig in toward the body of the guitar and see how it hit my thumb like that? So that's the idea. It launches over the pick and hits the thumb, but in this case, you want to choke up a little bit more. I had it like that so you could see what I was doing. So when we choke up a little bit, you can kind of tell where the sweet spot is on this guitar. Now, every guitar and pickup set are gonna have their own sweet spot. So definitely experiment and play up and down between around this area until you find the perfect sweet spot for you. Even every string is gonna have their own sweet spot. Now I'm gonna give you that demo on how you can apply this musically, and definitely remember to download this backing track in the description. So now it's your turn. I want to see you post your video response in the comments below of you jamming your own solo over this backing track. If this video was helpful to you, or you just really enjoyed this, please give it a thumbs up so I know, and subscribe for more content every Saturday. Find out next week who my top 5 instrumental artists are.